Welcome back, and we are in week two, video two, where we are going to continue on with the marine geology of the ocean floor, and in particular the actual materials that are present. And what we are going to be talking about in this video are the actual sediments that are present. So first of all, what are sediments? Well, they are the loose chunks of rocks or minerals or dissolved ions that are present either in the water as dissolved ions or being deposited or transported along coastlines or on the ocean floor. So the different types of sediments that we can see and that we collect and find on the ocean floor and on coastlines, you can see here. So we have ones that are called siliceous, which that term siliceous means there's quartz present, which has the chemical formula of SiO2, silicon dioxide. And we get siliceous sediments through the shells of various organisms building up after those critters die and their shells sink to the ocean floor. And also, if the water is actually very rich in dissolved silica, we can precipitate or form this ooze, this kind of gooey material that's all just made of silica on the ocean floor, which eventually will solidify into a sedimentary rock if conditions are right. We can also get very similar stuff but made out of calcite, and calcite is what will react to acid. It has calcium carbonate in it, or calcite, and these also come from organisms, and if there's a lot of dissolved calcite in the water column, we can also get this calcareous ooze building up on the ocean floor as well. When we get closer to continents, we have terrestrial or land-based sediments that are maybe traveling to the coast through rivers and streams. So we can see sands, gravels, and clays depositing close to those coastlines. Also, out in the deeper ocean, we can see some fine-grained mud, some clays, that finally have a chance to settle out of water. These clays take a little while to actually settle, similar to like watching a leaf or a feather or a piece of paper slowly settle down onto the ground. Clays have a very similar structure, and it takes very calm water for them to actually settle out and be deposited on the ocean floor. We can also get detritus, which is organic debris, dead organisms that settle to the bottom of the ocean floor. And if we're close to glaciers, so close to the poles near Antarctica or Greenland, we can get glacial debris being deposited. And these are very similar to the terrestrial deposits, sands, gravels, that are going to be transported by glaciers. So just to give you some pictures, kind of see what beach sediments can be composed of. Well, a lot of the actual beach sand or gravels that you see is a direct result or directly related to erosion from land and biologic activity offshore. So this idea of erosion from land, well, what kind of rocks are present close to that beach? Where's that sediment coming from? And if you pick up a handful of sand on a beach, you might see a variety of different things. I have several different examples here. We've got this green one, which is from a green sand beach in Hawaii. And the reason why it's so green is because the rocks that are directly around this beach have lots of this green mineral called olivine in them. So the beach tends to be very rich in olivine because it's actively eroding out of the cliffs around that beach. Same thing with this darker colored rock or sediment, sorry, that you can see here, that is eroded directly from darker igneous rocks. So we see mafic igneous rocks like basalts starting to break down and form those black sand beaches. We can also see maybe bits of rock salt, so halite crystals in some areas. Maybe we have a very shallow portion of our coastline, maybe a lagoon or a tidal flat, where when the tides go out, the water drains away. We may have a little bit of a puddle of water that tends to evaporate and leave those salts behind, so we can build up crystals that way. Tide comes back in, and we bring more of that salt water back into that basin to replenish that salt water supply, tide goes back out again, water evaporates, so on and so forth. In places where maybe we don't have a specific igneous rock weathering away, maybe we have a variety of different rocks, maybe we have mudstones, shales, sandstones, maybe we have some igneous rocks breaking down, we might get a variety of different rock fragments, and those tend to be kind of a darker grayish brown black color in your actual sediments. And then this bottom picture here, what has this lighter color to it, this light color is actually shell debris. So in this case, we have much more biologic activity going on off the coastline. So you have lots of ocean critters, things that have shells, living and dying offshore. As soon as they die, they're not fixed to their original position on the ocean floor anymore. The waves can wash them around, they break up into smaller particles, and then they get washed up on the beach. So if we see lots of shell debris in your beach sands, that's a sign that there's lots of biologic activity going on, lots of things living and dying offshore. If we see more of the rocks, particles, rock fragments, and mineral grains, we might have less biologic activity and more of just weathering of terrestrial rocks. So to kind of look closely at this sediment, and just an example here, this is a chunk of material that came from an Ireland beach. And this is what you guys are going to be doing in lab this week. You're going to look at a few different sand samples or sediment samples, and you're going to describe them. You're going to look at the grain size. Do we have mud, sands, gravels present? And in this one, I see a mixture of sands and gravels in this picture here. And we're also going to look at the actual shape of those grains. Are they rounded? Are they angular? Or are they kind of in between? So I would say these ones are in the middle category there, maybe sub-rounded or sub-angular. And then we're going to look at what it's made of. And in this case here, I see chunks of what looks like actually a light colored igneous rock. I see some mineral grains, I see some quartz. So I'd say we have a mixture of rock fragments and quartz. I don't see any calcite, any of those shell debris. So this is probably an area where we have lots of weathering from the land, very little biologic activity offshore. Another example of an environment where maybe there's a little bit more biologic activity, less weathering from the local rocks in the area. Because I see some darker colors in there, those are probably rock fragments. And then I see bits and pieces of shells that have been broken down and slightly rounded. So, and we can also test these with hydrochloric acid to see if they have any calcite present. So these mostly sand-sized grains, pretty well sorted. We don't see a mixture. And then I would say these are pretty in that sub-rounded category as well. And then of course, a little bit of rock fragments, but mostly shell material. So this would be maybe an area where there's lots of tide pools or reefs offshore. So just to give you an idea of where some of these things are gonna be forming, well, coarser sediments are going to be closer to land. So on our continental shelf, beaches, that's where we'll see the gravels and the sands, maybe the coarser shell material. As we get further and further out onto that continental shelf, we're still kind of in that maybe mud, sand, and broken up shell material, depending on if you have a reef nearby. But then when we get further out into the deeper ocean, this is where we start to have the clays starting to settle out. This is where we can get the silica ooze and the calcite ooze forming on our ocean floor. Now, the silica tends to be in deeper, cooler water because calcite tends to be unstable and it dissolves in the ocean water when it's cold and deeper. If we have warmer ocean water, the silica is not stable and it gets dissolved, and the calcite is what crystallizes. So on these continental shelves and warm environments, we're going to see lots of this calcareous ooze building up. Also, in the upper portion of the water column, what you see here is the sunlight zone. That area is where we have some of these microscopic critters floating in the water column that might be made of, their shells might be made of calcite or silica. Once they die, they settle to the ocean floor and build up over time. And then, of course, if you have like a whale or a fish that dies out in the open ocean, it's going to sink to the bottom, and we'll get some of that detritus building up as well. So to look at the actual thickness of sediment, if we take a look at maybe the United States, first of all, which we can see right over here, and we go on the east coast and follow, go out towards the center of the Atlantic Ocean, we notice we have lots of reds close to the coast, and as we get further and further out, we get into the blues. So what's happening here is we have thick deposits of sediments close to the coastline, and we have thinner deposits as you get further and further out into the center of the ocean. There's a few reasons for this. One reason is because we have lots of weathering on the coastline, bringing and transporting a lot of those coarser materials, building up right along the edge of that continent. The other reason could be the age of the ocean floor. So at the very center of the Atlantic Ocean, there's a divergent plate boundary pulling those continents apart. The younger rocks are going to be towards the center of that ocean, the older rocks towards the outside. The longer those rocks have been sitting there, the older they are, the more material can build up on that ocean floor. And we'll talk about this a little bit more detail when we get to plate tectonics next week. So where do we have different types of sediment on the ocean floor? This is a screen capture shot of the media that you'll have available to you on the course website, courtesy of Frank Granshaw. And what this media shows you are the various types of deposits. So we have terrigenous, so that's going to be derived by terrestrial environment, so on the actual continents. Biogenous deposits are going to have some kind of biologic activity associated with them. And then this last one, that's where we have some type of hydrothermal or water and hot fluids mixing together to form those sediments. So when you use this media, you can actually scroll over each of these different locations and highlight them. So if I scroll over, say, the clay deposits, we'll highlight the actual locations where clays are being deposited actively on the ocean floor. And then when you get a look at this media on your own, you can actually see some pictures of what that might look like on the right-hand side of the screen. I'll let you guys explore that on your own so you can see some pictures and explore a little bit. So if I look at calcareous here, we can see the calcareous debris building up in some of the warmer portions of the oceans. And then if we look at siliceous, we see siliceous sediments in mostly the cooler temperature environments. So pretty interesting. If we look at clays, those are the glacial sediments. Those are building up right at the edges of those glacial environments. Continental margin sediments, right around the edges of continents, closest to the source of those sediments. So when we take a look at what's made of the whole entire ocean floor, what do we typically see? Well, if we were to take a ocean voyage and take a core sample of the sediments and the rocks that are below those sediments, what we would see, so we would see gabbro on the bottom, we would see basalt on top of that, and then we would see layers of sediments on top of the basalts. And depending on where you are in the globe, those sediments might be calcareous, they might be land-based sediments, just kind of depends on what latitude you are, how close are you to the continents. And then layers of sedimentary rocks, if we're right next to the actual continent, you might see, instead of basalt and gabbro, you might see sedimentary rocks with sediments on top of those. So to kind of wrap things up, we just went through and talked about the different sediments that are present on the ocean floor, how we identify them and where they're located. In the next video, we're going to come back and talk about uplift gradation, surface processes, and how we collect these materials.